नमस्ते चिल्ड्रन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू आर फाइन। एंड इन द लास्ट क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड थ्री प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ होल नंबर्स। कैन एनीबडी नेम? यस, इट इज क्लोजर प्रॉपर्टी, कम्यूटेटिव प्रॉपर्टी एंड एसोसिएटिव प्रॉपर्टी। एंड वी हैव स्टडीड अंडर व्हिच अरिथमेटिक ऑपरेशंस दोस थ्री प्रॉपर्टीज वर सैटिस्फाइड बाय होल नंबर्स, दैट इज under addition and multiplication, those three properties were satisfied by whole numbers, whereas under subtraction and division, those three properties were not satisfied. Let us discuss one more property, it is distributive property of multiplication over addition. So far in the first three properties we have discussed with only one arithmetic operation, or from each, for addition means we have used only addition, for subtraction means we have discussed only for subtraction. But here this property is related to both two arithmetic operations, multiplication as well as addition. Now what is the statement for this distributive property of multiplication over addition? Let A, comma B and C are three whole numbers, or C, A, B and C are three whole numbers, or three whole numbers, or three whole numbers, then A into whole B plus C. A into whole B plus C means A is multiplied by sum of B and C, then we get A into B plus A into C, that is A is multiplied by B, A into B, then again property of multiplication over addition. We will check whether this property is satisfied by whole numbers or not with some examples. So where do we use this property? We use in solving the problems in the simpler way. We will discuss with some examples or even with some exercise sums the use of this distributive property. Now we will discuss with an example for this distributive property of multiplication over addition. So consider any three whole numbers. Let 2, 3 and 4 are 3 whole numbers. Then A into B plus C. Then A into whole B plus C, that is LHS we are taking. LHS is equals to A into B plus C here. A is equals to 2, B is equals to 3 and C is equals to 4. Write it. 2 into B is equals to 3 plus C is equals to 4. In the place of A, write as 2. In the place of B, write as 3. And in the place of 4, write as 4. Now simplify this. What we are getting? So how do we simplify? Again by using the Bartmann's rule. So 2 into, first we should simplify inside the brackets. 3 plus 4 is equals to 7. So 2 into 7 is equals to 14. So LHS what we got here is 14. Now we try for RHS. So RHS means right hand side. LHS means left hand side. So what we have on the right hand side? It is A into B, A into B plus A into C. So now here A is equals to what? First number 2 into B is equals to what? Second number is 3 plus again A is equals to 2 into C is equals to what? 4. 2 into 4. So what we get by multiplying this? 2 into 3 is equals to 6 plus 2 into 4, 2 4s are 8. Add both the products. 6 plus 8 is equals to 14. In both the cases, we got the same product of that. Therefore, we can write LHS is equals to RHS. LHS is equals to RHS. So, from this, you can conclude that the whole numbers satisfies the distributive property of multiplication and over addition. Over addition. We will discuss with one more example sum. See, you take the, say for example, if you want to find it is 12 into 35. Find the product of 12 and 35. That is 12 into 35. Here two numbers are there. We are interchanging this 12 into 35 as 12. We are writing or 35 also we can write here. 12 into 35 can be written as 30 plus 5. 35 can be written as 35 can be written as 30 plus 5. So now it is in the form of distributive property over multiplication over addition. That is A into B plus C. So how we will do this? First we need to multiply this to 12 into 30, we will get one product, plus 12 into 5, we will get another product. Add both the products, what we get? 12 into 30, how do you multiply? Multiply with 3, then keep 10 as we have 10 is there. 12 into 3, 12 3 is 36, and keep 0, 3 is 16, plus 12 into 5, 12 5 is 16, add both the sums. So what we get is 360 plus 16. When we add what we get, 0 plus 0 it is 0, 6 plus 6 it is 12, 3 plus 1, 4. So what we get is 420 we get. 420 we get. So here we use which property? It is distributive property we use to solve this sum. Without using distributive property also we can multiply directly. So 12 into 35, when we multiply with 12 into 35, what we will do? We will multiply with 5 first, then we will multiply with 3. The same concept only we used here it is. 5 2's are 10, 1 is there, 5 1's are 5, plus 1, 6, then with 3, we leave 1 is it, 3 2's are 6, 3 1's are 3. Add the numbers 0, 6 plus 6 is 12, 3 plus 1 is 4. So here we got again 420, and by using the distributive property also we got the same answer. So we use distributive property to solve some of the complex problems which are big numbers. By changing those numbers into distributive property form, then by simplification we will reach to the results. So what is distributive property here? Let A, B and C are three whole numbers, then A into B. A into whole B plus C is equals to A into B plus A into C. And this property is satisfied by the whole numbers. This property is satisfied by the whole numbers. Now we will discuss one more property. It is identity property. Identity property. See here. Under addition we will discuss. 1 plus 0 it is 1. 0 plus 1 it is 1. 7 plus 0 it is 7. 0 plus 7 it is 7. 0 plus 7 is also 7. 1 plus 0 1. 0 plus 1 1. 7 plus 0 7. 0 plus 7 it is 7. If you observe in these 4 additions, what is the common number? It is 0. Means we are adding 0 to a whole number, or a whole number is added to 0, or a whole number is added to 0, then what is the result? 1 plus 0, so 1 we got same number. 0 plus 1, 1 we got same number. 7 plus 0, 7 we got same number. 0 plus 7, 7 we got same number. It means that when a whole number is added to 0, or 0 is added to a whole number, the sum is the whole number which is added. The sum which we get the same whole number. This property is known as identity property under addition, and here 0 we call it as additive identity element of whole numbers. Additive identity of whole numbers. So from this what we can conclude? Let A, B 0 is equals to 0 plus a, that is equals to a. This property is known as identity property under addition. A plus 0 is equals to 0 plus a, that is equals to a itself. We will get only a only. This property is known as identity property under addition. And we call here 0 is the additive identity element of whole numbers. Additive identity element of whole numbers under whole numbers. 0 is the additive identity element of whole numbers. So which is the additive identity element of whole numbers? It is 0. Why 0 is the additive identity of element of whole numbers? When we add 0 to any whole number or any whole number is added to 0, we get the same whole number. Next, what about multiplication? Under multiplication, you see 7 into 1 is equals to 7 ones are 7. 1 into 7, 1 7s are 7. We got same here. 1 is multiplied with 7, or 7 is multiplied with 1. In both the cases, we got the product as 7. Then 10 into 1 is equals to 10. 1 into 10 is equals to what it is? A 10. 4 into 1 is equals to 4. 1 into 4, that is equals to 4. If you observe in all these cases, which element is common here? 1. So when 1 is multiplied by any whole number or any whole number is multiplied by 1, we are getting the same whole number as the product. This property is known as identity property under multiplication, and it is also satisfied by the whole numbers, as 1 is a whole number, 7 is also a whole number, 4 is a whole number, 10 is a whole number. So what is the statement here? It is, let A be any whole number, let A be any whole number, then A into 1, that is equals to 1 into A, that is equals to A. A into 1 is equals to what? A into 1 is equals to A we will get. 1 into A is equals to A only we will get. So that is same whole number A only we get. This property is known as identity property under multiplication. It is also satisfied by whole numbers. Now 1 is called multiplicative identity element of whole numbers. One is the multiplicative identity element of whole numbers. Multiplicative identity element of whole numbers. So this property is known as identity property, and it is satisfied under multiplication, under addition, not under subtraction and division. So this is identity property. So identity, which is the additive identity of identity element of whole numbers? 0. And which is the multiplicative identity element of whole numbers? It is 1. So this is identity property. Now, one more property, multiplication by 0, multiplication of a whole number by 0, what we get? Let's, 3 is a whole number, it is multiplied with 0, 3 into 0 it is, 3 zeros are 0, 4 into 0, 4 zeros are 0, 100 into 0 is equals to 100 into 0 it is 0, similarly, 0 into 1 is equals to 0, 0 into 99 is equals to 0. So what we can conclude from this, if any whole number is multiplied by 0 or 0 is multiplied by any whole number, the product is always 0. So the product of 0 and a whole number is always 0. Therefore, the product of the product of a whole number, the product of a whole number and zero is always zero. Is always zero. What about the division of a whole number by zero?
By zero.
7 by 0, what we get? 7 by 0, division is nothing but what? Repeated subtraction. So we need to subtract the 0 from 7. Repeated subtraction. When we subtract 7 minus 0, 7. Again, when we subtract the 0, 7. When we subtract 0, we get 7. So 7 only is repeating. Means it is not defined. It is not defined. Similarly, not defined, not defined. Similarly, if you take 2 by 0, so we are dividing 2 with 0. We are dividing 2 with 0. What we get? So it is, we need to subtract 0 from 2. 0 from 2. So when you subtract 0 from 2, what we get? 2 minus 0, 2. Keep minus sign here. So what we get? 2. Again you subtract 0, what we get? 2. Again you subtract 0, what we get? 2. So 2 is repeated. 2 is repeated, it is repeating. So there is no end here. Means the division of a whole number by 0 is not defined or not determined. Not defined. It is not defined. Therefore, what we can write? Division of a whole number by zero is not defined. Is not defined. So any whole number divided by zero is not defined or it is not determined. What about zero by any whole number? It is always zero only. That is, 0 by 8 is equals to 0. 0 by 100 is equals to 0. So when we divide 0 with any whole number, the result is 0 only. 0 by any whole number is 0. 0 by any whole number is 0. But any whole number divided by 0, it is not defined. So these are the properties which we have studied for whole numbers. Using these properties, we will solve some of the problems to understand clearly in detail by using these properties. Now, we will solve one example sum. Example, find the sum by suitable arrangement. By suitable arrangement means by regrouping the term numbers by using the properties of whole numbers and solve this, find their sums. See the first sum. Sum of 234 plus 197 plus 103. Repeat. 1962 plus 453 plus 1538 plus 647. You see here, three numbers are there. 234 plus 197 plus 103. That is equals to, by regrouping, by arranging this, you see here these two numbers in unit space, there is 7 plus 3, 10, you get 0. So we can add these two numbers easily, than these two numbers or than these two numbers. So you group them in one form. 234 plus 197 plus 103. So which property we are using here is associative property under addition. Is it clear? So which property we are using here? Associative property under addition. So now add. How do we do this? First we should simplify inside the bracket by using what? Bodmas rule. So 197 plus 103, what we get? 197 plus 103. So 7 plus 3, 10, keep 1 and 0 here. 9 plus 0, 9, 9 plus 1, 10, keep 1 and here is 0, 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 1, 3, 300. So how much we got? 300. Now 234 plus 300, add these two by using which property? It is closure property. So 300 plus 234, 0 plus 4, 4, 0 plus 3, 3, 3 plus 2, 5. So how much we get? It is 534. 534, therefore 234 plus 197 plus 103, that is equals to 534. So like this we will add the numbers. We will add the numbers by using the properties. Next you see the B picture. It is 1962 plus 453 plus 1538 plus 647. Here four numbers are there. You see here 2, here the unit space, and here it is 10, 8 in the unit space. By regrouping these two terms by using what? Commutative property. 1962 plus 1538, this is one group, plus next group, this is one group, and this will form one group. That is 453 plus 647 will form one group. So which property we use here? We change the order of the whole numbers. So what property we use here? It is commutative property. Commutative property. Commutative property. So which property we use here? It is commutative property. Now add these numbers. What, which numbers should add? 1962 plus 1538. So when we add, what we get? 2 plus 8, 10, keep 1 and it is 0. 6 plus 3, 9, 9 plus 1, 10, keep 1 and here it is 0. 9 plus 1, 10, 10 plus 5, 15, keep here 1 and it is 5. 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 1, it is 3. So how much we got? 3500 plus next two numbers. 453 plus 647. So add these two numbers. 3 plus 7, 10. So keep 0 here and 1 at here. 5 plus 4, 9. 9 plus 1, 10. Keep 0. 4 plus 6, 10. 10 plus 1, 11. So how much we got? 1100 we got. So now by adding these, what we get? So what are these numbers? This 3500. 3500 plus 1100. 0 plus 0 is 0. 0 plus 0 is 0. 5 plus 1, 6. 3 plus 1, 4. 4600. 4600 we got. Therefore, sum of 1962 plus 453 plus 1538 plus 647, that is equals to 4600. So we got the sum as 4600. So here by regrouping the terms, by regrouping the numbers and using the properties of whole numbers, we can find the sums easily in the simplest manner. So like this we can find the sums. So now in this class we studied some of the properties like distributive property one we have studied, and identity property we have studied, division of a whole number by zero we have studied, multiplication of a whole number with zero or by zero we have studied, and some of the their applications also we have used in solving the some of the problems. So from the whole lesson we have studied properties. That is, closure property is satisfied by the whole numbers and the addition and multiplication. Commutative property is satisfied by the whole numbers again under multiplication and addition. Associative property is also satisfied by whole numbers under addition and multiplication. And then distributive property we have studied, and identity property we have studied, and then division by zero, a whole number, division of a whole number by zero, we studied, and it is not defined. Which is the additive identity element of whole numbers? It is zero. And which is the multiplicative identity element of whole numbers? It is one. One is the multiplicative identity element of whole numbers, and zero is the additive element of whole numbers. Additive element of whole numbers. So any whole number divided by zero is not defined, and zero divided by any whole number is always zero. Zero into any whole number or any whole number into zero is always zero. Zero plus any whole number is the same whole number we get. So all these properties and some properties about these whole numbers we have studied in the sixth standard. So now, and if we come to the homework, homework part, page number 37, example 2, page number 37 from your textbook, example 2, and page number 40, exercise number 2.2, first question in that A. Next, prepare a table and write the properties of whole numbers in the class workbook like this. I have given an example. Name of the property, arithmetic operation, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Whether the property is satisfied under that arithmetic operation or not, you have to write. So for example, closure property under addition is satisfied, and closure property under subtraction, what happens is it is not satisfied. Under subtraction is not satisfied, then multiplication is satisfied, and the division it is not satisfied. Like this, you complete the table. And I hope you understand the properties of whole numbers and their applications. In the next class, we will study how to solve some of the problems using the properties of whole numbers. Thank you once again.